Hello. So we will try to see if we can do something about this particular idea to create an admin interface for DickMaker. So DickMaker is a server app for publishing online dictionaries like Olam and Olam will do this search for a word and it gives you the dictionary. Burn actually means say do or something like that. How do we contribute? Build with DickMaker. Okay, so essentially, at least Olam has a way to add new words, and please go to DickMaker, standalone website for rapidly building English full-fledged dictionary websites and APIs for any language. Now, what is required is the be useful to have an admin front end or dashboard on top of DickMaker for managing dictionary entries, add, remove, search, edit, moderate public submissions. For instance, on Olam, there are a number of public submissions, new words, definitions, and corrections come through regularly. A UI tailor-made for easily moderating such submissions can add great value to a dictionary website. Manage changes to the Postgres table schema, addition of CRUD handlers and SQL operations on the Go app, add, remove, delete, approve, reject. A web-based dashboard as a management front end to the CRUD operations, preferably in Vue.js. So, first thing you need to do, we need to try to get this working on our computer. So I am just going to copy this. Not clone that. Okay, so DickMaker is now on my computer, except that I have to think I need a Go installed. A contributing dot md, no contributing dot md. So I'm just gonna see how Go works in Arch. Standard compiler is Go. Go tools. So let me install those. And I can run something with go run hello and build with go build hello. Try that. Go run. Okay. What should I run? Let me try go run. No go files listed. Go run go. Go run go dot mode. Okay, so by now you will have realized I know very little about Golang. So we will see how to do things in Golang. Okay, go run dot. No go files. Maybe I have to run go run tickmaker or cmd, but okay, I'm just very quickly seeing if I can find a simple way to run this. Let me first open this in editor. There's a make file here. That's good. So dips will do this, build will do this. Okay, so let's just run make. Now, okay, there's a dip maker which has come up now. Which makes sense. So essentially, what we needed to do was run make and make would run the right build commands. Now what we need is to document that somewhere so that if someone starts using this. Okay, let's do one thing. What's the quickest way to solve this? We could add in the readme. So let me check out branch. Where are we now? Git status. We are in master. We check out FMB add docs. And in readme, we will add actually, let's not add anything in readme. Let's create a contributing dot md file. And let's contributing dot md. Let's see how GitHub gives us a template or not. Okay, doesn't give us a template, so we would rather create our own. To get TickMaker compiled on here on local system, use the command make, which will generate TickMaker binary in your okay. So first we have to do let's make this one down. One clone this repository onto your computer, switch to the folder, rerun make for let's add a zero here. Make sure you have go installed and make and then slash TickMaker is now available, but it also needs a config tone. Does this talk about config? Yep, it says run TickMaker new. Follow the rest of installing installation instruction in readme.it. Okay, let's keep that as it is. Now what else do we need? We need let's see what there is in config address. Postgres. Okay, so we need now Postgres. Postgres to add to the to configure the DB section of config.dml. You will need a Postgres instance running on your computer. So let's make Postgres run on our computer. Arch Postgres. Install PostgreSQL package. and then do this. Sudo hyphen u postgres hyphen I. Init db arlib postgres data success. Now what? Oh, I wonder if Postgres locally affects DeepMaker in some way or the other. Anyhow, we are just gonna start the PostgreSQL service now. Not as Postgres user, can't do it as Postgres user. Sudo system control start PostgreSQL as me. Okay, now sudo fnu postgres create user interactive name of role to add with maker super user. No, should they create a database? We're passing a DB name, so no. Okay, so let's try putting DeepMaker there, and then we need to do a create DB. Can I create the same? Okay, DB name is DeepMaker, and I had to copy that to config.yml first. I'm just gonna now let me run DeepMaker. What should I run? Oh, I should have run DeepMaker new to generate the sample. Let me move this to and let me do DeepMaker new. Unable to initialize embedded file system using local file config generated. So first thing, is this different from our backup? No, so we're just gonna say move this to config dump. Now that this has been moved to config, we can do DeepMaker install. First time installation. This will wipe existing DeepMaker tables and types in the DB Correct. Successfully installed schema. Okay, so now we have to actually populate the tables, but for now let's try this. Status success data, welcome to DeepMaker. Query API. From lang to lang word. Okay. I wouldn't expect that to have worked because we didn't add anything. Sample dictionary. Sample. Insert into entries English, something like that. So we need to tell people how to so one install PostgreSQL. Two, create user. Fill config.term with these details. Three is we need to import this, right? So we'll do this. Okay, let me see if I'll get this correct. PSQ, let's not do it. Sudo hyphen one second. Okay, sudo hyphen Postgres to run this as Postgres and sudo run PSQL and run it on DeepMaker and run from the file sample. Error sample.sql, no such file in the directory. Okay, because Postgres user couldn't. Okay, let me run this as just PSQL. And okay, so I ran it as user Postgres on PSQL and seemed to have worked, so I can add that. Actually, I should have been able to do this as DeepMaker use also. Anyhow, let's leave it at that. Now, let's running again. Yep, so Apple is working. API dictionary English Apple. Okay, it's not being sent as a JSON, which is why it's a text plane, which is why it's not showing up as so. Nice JSON, but that's fine. Is there a way to view this as JSON? View JSON. There's a way to make open JSON viewer. Maybe if I, yeah, so the response is data is an object with the data which has entries, and one entry and things like that. Okay, now that's not our concern at the moment. Next thing you need to do is we need to figure out how this works. Search query entry how does the API work? Go dot mod is dependencies. I think these are some check files. These are probably template files for creating the schema. Okay, there's api.go net http. Handle search to search. From lang to lang queue. Get grocery words, get pagination. Validate search query. So is this search that we did? We did API dictionary English English Apple. Main.go. Need to do to. Okay, main.go is as command line options. App dot search is search. register g.new router register handlers are app. So g is what is g? G G G G G go G. G should be some kind of server, lightweight idiomatic composable router for building Go HTTP services. Now if it's a router, where is the root? Register handlers are app. Where is app defined? Okay, firstly, why is Go? Are there extensions for Go? Golang tools. Okay, I just installed Golang tools in Visual Studio. How does this work? Oh, go path is home HD go. I didn't want go path to be my home folder. Anyhow. Initialize app context. App has constants. App is so big. How is app able to? Okay, there's a register handle. Okay, sorry. Register handlers is in what? It's in init.go. So if app constant site not equal to empty, dictionary from lang to lang q, which is also here, API dictionary from lang to lang q, wraps, wrap and handle search. What does wrap do? Okay, wrap does something like that. There's a way to go back. Go back is control alt minus what? Handle search. So handle search is the thing which does it. Do search our app. Send response, okay, resp. It should have sent an application JSON. Didn't send an application JSON. Did it send an application JSON? explain. Because see, it's supposed to send. Let's go to control. It's supposed to send write header status. There's no status for that. Let's see if this is a function that does get called. I'm going to make it again, run it again, see if this changes to test success. It did change, which means that is the function that runs. Why did that not work? W dot header set is content type. Go content type JSON text plain. What's happening? Right click. Other users are responding. You have to set the current type first, W, and then HTTP. Then the HTTP response code W.write header. If you call W.write header first and call W header, that after you'll get plain text. Okay. That's brilliant. So we'll do that and then we'll do this and then quit. Make. And so if everything goes right and I refresh this, this will look like a JSON. Yep. And that's because this is now correctly returning application JSON, which is nice. So So we will have to do a couple of things. There's a contributing dot empty which we can add to a commit, and we can say git commit m docs add developer documentation, and git remote add hds git add github.com gitmaker.git and git push hd branch add docs. Now we go to master, we check out branch saying fix JSON error, and then we say add, then we say it's incorrect header for JSON response, and we give that reference. Then we do that. Right, so now let's come back to, let's just continue working on this branch. What do we need? Okay, let's just first figure out how the search function works. Handle search. So it gets app instance from somewhere. And then it does a do search. Do search is what actually does a search. Do search takes from lang to lang queue. And one escapes the query, probably to prevent SQL injection. And creates a query something. Okay, this is probably the query in the response. Okay, let's not worry about what it is now. This is just the query, or yeah, so this is where the actual query happens. Dot search dot find entries. Stored query search select. This is the search. Where is actually defined? Okay, Go is kind of weird. I think this is a return, or is this the return? I mean, this should be the function param. I should learn Go, I think. S dot queries dot search. Search. Okay, this is query search. Now, how do I find the search query? So this queries.sql. It's probably reading from this. So search. Prepare TS query tokens. Okay. Order by rank, etc. Okay, so that's what happened. So essentially, BitMaker runs and it registers these handlers, especially this one, and every time a call is made to this, it runs handle search. Handle search will take do search. Do search will take the parameters from the URL and clean it up and all of that, and then do find entries. Find entries will return the entries filtered and filtered by a given query along with the total number of matches in the data. We'll do all of that by using the query as specified in this. Now, so let's go back to this. There needs to be changes to Postgres table schema. What change would that be? So imagine the word entries would have ID, GUID, content. Wait, tokens. All of that is there, right? So this probably needs moderation status. I don't know, would it be an enum? It's an enum in SQL int something. And in queries, there will have to be a query to query things which are not moderated. There's another problem. If someone has submitted something and while moderating, the moderator thinks that it needs to be edited, there'll have to be an edit option as well. Maybe that's for later. So essentially there will have to be a endpoint which searches only for words which are not moderated and returns. And there'll have to be an endpoint which says approved and changes that to approved. So essentially there has to be an endpoint which queries and writes. So one read endpoint, one write endpoint. I mean, it would require a query first and then in somewhere in these an API and all that. Okay, doing that will not happen today, but what we will do is we'll just make a pull request out of the two commits we did make, that one and this one. Apparently the order of these statements not only changes the content type. And helps people to get started. Okay, fine. So that done, we will just leave it at this today. See you in the next video.